What's up, basketball fans? Balik bareng Rocky Padila. Hari gue ada highlight sih dari showcase tim Nasional Basket Indonesia, di mana ini menjadi ajang untuk Coach Rajko Toroman melihat kemampuan para pemain IBL yang dipanggil ke showcase kali ini. Dan juga ini dibagi dua tim, tim hijau dan tim putih. Dari tim putih tadi ada Oki Wira yang menjadi top scorer, sedangkan dari tim hijau ada Vincent yang baru aja balik dari China dan mainnya langsung gokil banget. Mencetak 23 poin, serta ada satu pemain amatir yang diselipin yaitu Yuda Saputra dari ITHB. Dan Yuda pun walaupun poinnya gak terlalu banyak, tapi yang pasti Yuda menjalankan tugasnya menjadi point guard luar biasa banget. Bolanya ngalir banget tadi untuk tim yang hijau. So guys, selain ada highlights, nanti ada interview juga dengan Coach Rajko Toroman. So guys, langsung kita ke highlights ya. Jangan lupa untuk like, jangan lupa untuk komen, dan jangan lupa untuk subscribe. Thank you guys for watching. Enjoy the highlights.
It's very difficult. We just practicing 2 days, and now we will play the game, and we will see. But There are a few interested, you know, players, and I hope that we can continue to work with them. You know, we have to make a little bit bigger pool of the players who know the system, how to play, who know the way of the practicing, what we are doing. And I think in next period after Medan we will do that, invited some more players and practice with them and put them in a system what we want to play.
What was your first impression of the Indonesian basketball?
I have to say that I start to worry when I saw our team on John's Cup, you know, because I was not there with Indonesian national team, I was with one Philippine selection, you know, Mighty Sport. And when I saw our players, how they are struggling, you know, I start to worry about us. But later on, you know, when we start to practice, I think that we can improve a lot. In front of us is a hard work, you know, just work, work and work. Because only way how we can catch the other national teams is a hard work and work more than anybody else in Asia. That's only way how we can succeed it. And also, you know, we don't have a size, that's definitely, you know, and with one American big guy, he can change a lot, you know.
Talking about the American big guy, there's rumor that you guys might naturalize Denzel Bowles. Is that true or is it how?
But it's not so far from true, you know. We were talking with Denzel, I was talking with him, I met him in when I was in Manila. I was talking, he's willing to come. And I think that there is a big chance to come here because we need a really good player to be competitive. If Philippines have a Blatch, you know, and Korea had a Ratliff, we need some guys who can be competitive with these two guys.
So what is the next step after this process?
The next step is to work a lot and to have some international games. You know, that's also very important for us to prepare our team for the SEA Games. I hope that our naturalized player will join us in October, beginning of October. And then we have 2 months to prepare the team and to make adjustment with the big guy, because we'll play without big guy next 2 months. But, you know, we have to be ready, and we have enough time to prepare the team for the SEA Games.
Bye.